Hey guys, give me a few minutes. I want to show you how to put a dormer window up in the roof of your house. It's the little window that sticks out of the shingles of the house. This is not for everyone to do and it's not mandatory, but it's something that some of you may want to attempt. So we're going to go over it real quick. First thing you need to do is just like you would do with the window down below, you draw the top and bottom window lines and then the sides. Vertical and vanishing lines, okay? Vanishing, top and bottom, vertical, side to side, okay? So just like I drew this window on a wall, you would do the exact same thing on your roof, okay? You'd start with the bottom line, same as this, the top line, same as this. These two are going to the same vanishing point, okay? And then we would determine where we want the sides to be with the verticals. So we have vertical and vanishing, just like this. Same basic idea as the window in the front of the house. The only difference is the entire window here is married to that wall. It's touching it on all four corners. On this one, it's only touching down here at the bottom because that roof is leaning away from it going back. So what we want to do is take this point right here and parallel to this line, we're going to draw a line up the roof like so, okay? And that's going to allow this whole shape to lay back on the roof line, all right? So we continue on with our window just like we would at an end of a house. We do our center point, we do our vertical line up, we pull our peak down, and this gives us this whole front shape right here, okay? And from that point, we're going to draw back towards this vanishing point from these two points. Okay? That will give us those two points. Now, this is not perfectly two-point perspective, but for right now, we're going to call it good, and we'll get into the more specifics as we go. But when you take the extra off of this, that's going to allow that part to marry down to that roof. It's going to join it as it's all laid down together. We could go back eventually and come underneath this just a little bit and draw this line, and that would allow for this to be your overhang. And then, of course, you can always pull this out and create this overhang. Give you that shape on the roof. Okay? So, not perfect two-point, but enough to get us a shape on the roof that will be closer to what we're looking for.